subscribe to this channel and turn on your notification bell icon. Thank you. Hello, my wonderful people. Welcome back to my channel. Today, I bring to you a news coming from Edo State. Drama as Obaseki pulled down Edo Assembly roof over impeachment scare. There was a mild drama on Thursday at the Edo State House of Assembly, located in Ring Road, Axis of Benin City, as the roofs of the assembly complex were forcefully pulled down. It was gathered that the move comes following the foiled forceful takeover of the assembly by 17 lawmakers of the APC and loyalists of the party's governorship candidate, Pastor Osage Ezeyamo. The order was reportedly issued by the state governor, Mr. Godwin Obaseki, and his deputy, Philip Shuaibu, who have since decamped to the People's Democratic Party, PDP, from the APC. It was reported how security agencies, believed to be drafted from Abuja, on Thursday stormed the Edo Assembly complex to provide security cover to the 17 APC lawmakers and Ezeyamo's loyalist. The move, which was to allow fresh inauguration of APC loyalist and impeachment of the Speaker Frank Okiye, the governor and his deputy Philip Shuaibu, was however foiled when Obaseki, Shuaibu and supporters stormed the complex. Our correspondent later observed that talks were immediately drafted to forcefully pull down the roof of the Edo Assembly under the guise that it needed to be replaced with new ones. Earlier, heavy-duty trucks from Edo Government House were seen heaping sand and other construction materials at the front of the assembly gate under the guise that renovation was ongoing. It was as well gathered that the moves were to prevent the APC and the Abuja forces from forcefully taking over the assembly. A dummy maze at the top of the roof over fears that it could be used to carry out the impeachment plan. The pro-Obaseki lawmakers have been sitting inside the Edo State Government House, also known as Osadebe Avenue, for over a month, claiming that the assembly complex at Ring Road was being fumigated over COVID-19 scare. The relocation of Edo Government House, it was learned, was to monitor the pro-Obaseki lawmakers and ensure they remain true to the governor's causes until the September 19th governorship election. According to Governor Obaseki, he said that they are going to resist attempts to illegally take over the Edo Assembly. Governor Obaseki of Edo State said on Thursday that the state will resist any attempt by anybody to forcefully take over the state House of Assembly. While addressing newsmen at the assembly complex in Benin, Obaseki said that he would do anything within his constitutional powers to protect the sovereignty of the house and the state. The governor's statement was not unconnected with media reports credited to the Speaker of the House, Francis Okiye. Okiye had alleged that Governor Hope Uzodinma of Imo and impeached Deputy Speaker of the House, Yekini, had planned to import a fake maze to violently take over control of the assembly. Nigeria is governed by the constitution, and President Muhammadu Buhari has always said we should follow the rules of the law and do things according to the law. For us as the executive, we will use the instruments available to us constitutionally to protect the house and the state, Governor Obaseki said. The governor, however, urged the House to go about its normal duties as the parliament as prescribed by the constitution. Also, the deputy governor, Philip Shuaibu, said the state government would not allow other members of the assembly whose seats have been declared vacant to take over the House. According to him, the affected elected registrars had yet to be constitutionally inaugurated. He also called on the president to intervene in the alleged plot to destabilize the state assembly. Meanwhile, the entrance and the exit gates of the assembly complex have been barricaded with sand and gravel, while some people have seen removing the roof of the building. The speaker said the house was currently under renovation and the presence of the security operatives at the entrance of the complex scared the contractor and the workers away. "We are going to keep vigil here for forestall the alleged illegal invasion of the house by anybody," Okiyi said. All right, my wonderful people, this is all the news we have for you coming from Edo State. Before I permit you to drop what you think concerning this, permit me to make my own stand. From the news I read, it said that drama unfolded as Obaseki pulled down Edo Assembly roof over impeachment scare. If you have been following our recent news, you will find that there have been so much drama happening in Edo State between the sitting governor, Governor Godwin Obaseki, the deputy Shuaibu, and then again their opposition party, which is the APC, represented by Pastor Osage Iziamu. Things have not really been right. So many things have been going on that day. Just this morning, we are told how men invaded the Eblia, how they forcefully took over the assembly. That is the 17 lawmakers of the APC and the loyalists of the party's governorship candidates, Osage Iziamu, how they took over the assembly this morning. And so many other things have been happening. If I'm to say that is a very wrong mood, and I don't even know who gave them the authority to march into the assembly and want to take it over forcefully. Things are not done that way, and government really need to look into it. Then coming to Governor Obaseki trying to pull down the assembly roof over the impeachment scare, I must say that things are not done forcefully. Like, he shouldn't use because of the impeachment scare and do things that he's not supposed to do. We should not support violence, disruption of peace and order. Although Obaseki is a fighter, but this fight shouldn't be done with violence, because if we continue with violence, the peace and order will not be maintained in the country. And then again, following the September 19th election, if they continue using so much force, so much disruption to follow it, I don't think INEC will allow the election to hold. So I think the government, the Nigerian government, Buhari government, should really look into this matter happening in Edo State, because it's not helping at all. Permit me to read out some of the grievances and some of the comments coming from Nigerians. One of the comments I have here said, "If those after him really want to remove him, this can't stop them. Political drama at its best." Then this other comment I have here said, "In as much as I don't support violence, I think peace and order is the thing we should accumulate in this country. Once a fighter, always a fighter. That Owe blood still they flow inside Governor Obaseki." Then the next comment I have here said, "This is one of the reasons why Amaechi said, you need a special kind of grace to survive this monkey water of Nigerian politics. Adams Oshomole is an Aryan. He won't back off from this fight." Then the next comment I have here said, "Nigerian politics is real comedy. This is serious work on site. In all this, there should be no bloodshed in Edo State. That is all we called for." Then the next comment I have here said, "Nigeria, what a place. We are all comedians. All heavenly beings must be entertained. We no get shame at all. Ordinary governorship, nine, they make us create all this content. No wonder the Bible says that he has created all things, and for his pleasure, they are and were created." Then the last comment I'll take here says, "This is seriously serious. Governor Obaseki seems to know how to counter every Oshomole move and always ambush him. Oshomole did the same thing in 2014 and now he's repeating it again in this 2020. Alright, my wonderful people, right now I'm going to allow you to drop your opinion and what you think concerning this at the comment section. We would like to know how you feel, we would like to know your thoughts, we would like to know what you think concerning this news at the comment section. See you in my next video, but don't forget to subscribe to this channel and do wait to turn on your notification bell icon to get notified whenever we make a new upload. See you in my next video. Thank you. Thank you.